And I asked them, can I do both? And they said, no, you have to choose either one.
President, how are you, sir?
I'm very good. Thank you very much. This will be very exciting.
Now, I have a question from Danny Segura from USA Today. He wants to know, how did you become a boxing fan, President?
Well, during the course of my business career, I've held many, many fights. So I had Evander, and a great champion, really great champion, and Mike Tyson. We all know about Mike and so many others. I've held many, many fights. And over the course of time, I just really learned to like it. I'd much rather watch it than do it, but I learned to really like it, and the fans like it. There's nothing like a great fight, and I've had plenty of them.
Well, you are obviously ingrained in combat sports. Kevin Ioli of Yahoo Sports wants to know, he states that Evander Holyfield is the only man to have defeated both Lennox Lewis and Mike Tyson. Where do you think Evander fits on the all-time scale when you consider that he was both undisputed at both cruiserweight and heavyweight and holds victories over the likes of Mike Tyson, Larry Holmes, and George Foreman?
So Evander was always a smaller heavyweight, and the one thing you knew, whether it was 250 or 260, Evander would fight a lot at around 218, but you knew no matter how big they were, no matter how good they were in for a very rough evening. And they were, I saw some of the greatest Evander fights. He had the famous 10th round, as you know, and I think it was one of the greatest rounds in the history of, we thought, Evander was knocked out, and Evander came back, and by the end of the round, you know what happened. It was just an amazing fight. But anybody that fought Evander, whether they weighed, you know, in the mid-200s, there were a lot of 260s at that time. Evander was just brutal. Also, Evander is a light heavyweight. I call it light heavyweight, but as a light heavyweight, Bob Foster, I would say, was right up, I think Evander would say, was right up there, and Evander, I think Evander probably goes down as the greatest light heavyweight, but he wanted to go heavyweight. And even though he was, generally speaking, almost always lighter than other fighters, he was better than almost all of them. He was a great, great champion.
Steve Kim from the Three Knockdown Rule Boxing Podcast wants to know, what was the most memorable boxing event that you hosted at your property in Atlantic City?
Well, I'd have to say, I mean, it was a disappointment in a sense because it didn't last very long. I think it was 97 seconds, but it was Tyson Spinks. And as you know, Michael was he was doing great. He was another great, by the way, he was a great light heavyweight, and he went up to heavyweight. He was doing really well with his speed. But Mike Tyson was ferocious at that time. And it was Tyson Spinks was certainly a big event. We had people coming in from Europe, coming in from all over the world. And unfortunately, by the time they sat down, the fight was over. We were ushering people in, and they were walking to their seats and being treated beautifully. And we said, I'm sorry, sir, you might as well go in the other direction because this fight just ended. I think it was 97 seconds, but it was very quick, first round. And Mike Tyson was a ferocious fighter, and especially at that point in his career, it was very early in his career. I think I had more Mike Tyson fights than anybody else by far, a lot of them. And he was an incredible, I don't know how Evander feels, because Evander was tough on Mike, but I will tell you, Mike was really somebody that was always very good to me, very nice to me, and he was a great fighter.
President Trump, George Ebro from the Miami Herald wants to know, we knew you were close to Evander Holyfield in his heyday. What does it mean for you to be commentating one of his fights on Saturday night?
Well, it's one of the reasons I'm doing it. And I tell you what, I have been close to Evander. I've been with Evander during some incredible times and during some of his incredible wins. And I've seen Evander in a little bit of a bad time, but he always came out of it. He's a great guy, and he's a great, great fighter. I know Evander's family, and he's a very special guy. Tremendous heart. Now, you know, when they talk about Evander, he was always in incredible physical shape. He probably had zero body fat. I think there was probably nobody with, less as we call it, body fat. But Evander was always in shape. But better than his body was his heart. The guy was just a fantastic person. I don't even know if he can hear me now. I hope he can.
Well, we're listening.
But Evander had tremendous heart.
Want to say something? Evander has something to say to you, President Trump.
I'm well, good. Hi, Evander.
I'm good. How are you doing?
I'm doing good. I'm doing good. Thanks, Evander.
Well, you know, I truly appreciate the opportunity that I had at
in Atlantic City, Trump Taj Mahal.
Yeah.
Beautiful
Atlantic
place.
City, because that's when I beat George Foreman. And pretty much all, I was undefeated in Atlantic City anyway. Yeah.
What a memorable event. Also, President Trump, my final question. This comes from Josh Peter of USA Today. If you had to box somebody on Saturday night, who would it be and what would the fight look like?
Well, if I had to pick somebody in the world, not only a professional boxer, because I'll take a pass on the professional boxers, that can be a very dangerous subject. But if you said, if I had to box somebody?
Anybody.
I think probably my easiest fight would be Joe Biden, because I think he'd go down very, very quickly. Very, very quickly. You know, he once said, oh, I'd like to take him behind the bar, and he'd be in big trouble if he ever did. Now, I think Biden would go down within the first few seconds.
The first few seconds. All right, President Trump, thank you so much for your time. We will see you on Saturday night. Ladies and gentlemen, round of applause for the President of the United States of America, Donald J. Trump.
Oh, Ed,
thank you very much. Great
honor.
Thank
hold on, President Trump. Vitor has something to say real quick to you.
Hey, I will add a Coleman event, Mr. Trump. It's going to be Trump Jr. versus his son. That's a Coleman event.
The Coleman event. Is,
yeah.
And this is another great champion, let me tell you. I'm talking right now to another great champion. And that's going to be a very interesting evening. I think people are going to have a great time, and it's going to be great. And Vitor is a fantastic fighter. Always has been for a long time.
All right. Thank you so much, President Trump. Again, a round of applause for the President of the United States of America. And let me tell you that President Trump is a big fight fan and has crazy knowledge of boxing and MMA.